The decline in economic performance was widespread in the primary and secondary sectors. Mining contracted by 6.1%, driven by a fall in the production of platinum group metals, coal and iron ore, while manufacturing weakness was mainly due to the decrease in the manufacturing of basic iron, steel and machinery products. Agriculture is also down on the back of weakness in field crops such as maize and wheat. The local economy was expected to grow at 0.5% this year, but analysts say this points to even lower economic growth levels.
It sort of reflects the downturn that we are in, and unfortunately it seems that the downturn deepened in the third quarter when we had actually expected a bit of a rebound. It's very worrying because remember the third quarter unemployment numbers, this could mean that there were even more job losses, for instance, in the fourth quarter.
The Agriculture Business Index released by the Agricultural Business Chamber of South Africa, ACBIS, and the IDC fell slightly from 46 points in the third quarter to 44 points in the fourth quarter. A level below the neutral 50-point mark implies that agribusinesses are still downbeat about the business conditions in South Africa. Chief Economist at ACBIS, Wandile Sihlobo, says the index has been at levels below the 50-point mark for six consecutive quarters, its lowest streak since 2010. He says this has been underpinned by both unfavorable agriculture policy environment and weather conditions. Motorists will have to dig deeper in their pockets to fill up this festive season. The price of petrol went up by 22 cents per litre this week, pushing the price of petrol to 16.30 per litre in Gauteng. The National Association of Automobile Manufacturers of South Africa, NAMSA, reports a fall in total vehicle sales to just below 45,000 in November, its lowest since 2010. Economists say the domestic vehicle market is likely to remain under pressure in the coming months on the back of weak economic prospects and subdued credit demand. South Africa's current account deficit narrowed to 3.7% of GDP from 4% as the trade account switched to a surplus. Economists say the figures continue to reflect the generally subdued conditions in the domestic economy. Next week, Stats SA will release the manufacturing production figures, the consumer price index and the retail trade sales. Lorasa Fakomosi, SABC News, Johannesburg.